My apologies in advance for some inconsistent frame rate issues throughout this Let's Play. It's not something I noticed until after I finished recording the entire thing, and I can't fix it in post-production. I would just go back and re-record everything, but I already know the solutions to the puzzles, so that won't work either. Fortunately, the issue doesn't happen that often, so I hope you'll enjoy my Myst Let's Play just the same. Which begins right now. Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play here on Game Time. My name is Jonathan Paula. We are going to go back in time. 22 years, to be specific, to 1993, when Cyan released Myst, a groundbreaking point-and-click puzzle exploration game that totally blew my mind as a kid and gave me fantastic opportunities to hang out and bond with my father. Some of my fondest gaming memories as a child are playing this on our Packard Bell way back in 1994. This is realMyst Masterpiece Edition, a 3D re-release.
I realized the moment I fell into the fissure, the book would not be destroyed as I planned. I continued falling into that starry expanse of which I had only a fleeting glimpse. I've tried to speculate where it might have landed, but I must admit that such conjecture is futile. Still, the questions about whose hands might one day hold my Myst book are unsettling to me. I know my apprehensions might never be allayed, and so I close, realizing that perhaps the ending has not yet been written.
Well, I hope not. Because if the book was already written and it already ended, what the hell are we doing here? So, a sort of very small and very confusing and not really expositional prologue that sort of gets you into the mood for where this game is going to take us. It involves books, it involves rifts through space, but beyond that, I don't want to spoil it. This is, as I've mentioned in past Let's Plays, an amnesia run to the nth degree because it has literally been 2 decades since I've played this. I forget all of the puzzles. What I do remember is the challenge. I remember the island we're going to go back to. So let's open up the titular book and revisit the island of Myst. Oh man, this is like a trip down nostalgia lane, and I'm going to have plenty of time to relive all these memories. This is going to be a fun Let's Play. We haven't done anything like this on Game Time in a long time. So we have two control schemes, Classic Myst and Free Roam. I'm going to go with Classic. I love that this remastered version has done all of the graphics, which used to just be static JPEG images, into a 3D world you can move around like a first-person shooter. But I like the old style, even with the updated graphics. Here we are. We are on the island of Myst. You have the crickety boat behind us over here. If I can examine it, right? There's not a lot here. Your mouse, rather, your cursor changes sort of looks when you have an option to turn around. So let's go to the right, see what's behind us. Nothing here. Take a right again. We have a door. Why not? Let's go down here, the creepy dark tunnel first. All right, let's pop the flashlight on. That's F on your keyboard for those playing home at home. Home by yourself is what I meant to say. Let's go down these creepy stairs. All right, what do we got here? Ooh. Wow, 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 wow. Sounds like a TIE fighter or something taking off. All right, what else we got back here? Oh, this music, holy shit. There's nothing like smells and music to just instantly transport you to another time and place. All right, so this button doesn't do anything yet, but see that note we have over there? What is my guy? Is he doing a? I think he was just doing like the Khmer symbol with his finger. When I say he, I'm talking about our cursor, our little floaty hand in space. All right. So what does this say? Can we read it? Here we go. Settings: dimensional imager. Topographical extrusion test. Maker switch diagram. Water turbulent pool. Is this the water turbulent pool? I think so. Oh, shit. Go back. I missed it. Water turbulent pool. 67, but if I do other things, I can look at other... All right. Let's try the exclusion test, which is number 40. And then activate. What did that do? Did that set it up? Let's give this another push. Oh, okay, look, it actually worked. So now we have a topographical extrusion test of... I don't know what. It doesn't look like the island. That's one of the few things I remember about this game is I know my way around. I don't remember the challenges or the puzzles, but I sort of have a vague recollection of what the area looks like. And if you've ever played GoldenEye or Perfect Dark as a kid, you go back to those old maps, like, you know, the temple map and the facility. Like, you still know your way around those bathroom stalls at that Soviet dam. There's just something about video games that stay with us for a long time, and I've always been really fascinated by that. So if I click this button, does it... Oh, shit. All right, so... Now let's go back over here. What do we have inside? We have a spaceship with... I don't know what... Shit! Did I fuck that whole thing up? Let's try 47 now. See if that does anything different. Well, obviously it's gonna do something different. We just have to find out why is different and what it does. All right, let's spin around here. Let's click the button and activate it. Oh, sweet. Now this was, what did we call this? What was this? This was the maker switch diagram. All right. Oh, no, stay on. I don't want you to turn off. No reason for that. I don't know if this point and click was the best. Maybe the free roam would be easier. What did I just do? I don't know. I don't know what I just did. We gotta go around. Let's go back up the stairs and get out of here. So that's a bunch of stuff that we just did. And Myst is a fantastic game for making you feel like you've made progress when really you've done absolutely nothing. And by the same token, it is a fantastic game for making you completely just claw your own hair out of your head as you try to figure out what any of this shit does or what its significance is. And Myst, the first in a 5-game series, you know, we'll flip the switch and of course nothing will happen. We're not going to know what that switch does for a while. But that's part of the excitement, that's part of the fun, is trying to figure out what all of this stuff has to do with each other. So we threw that switch, but we have a giant, you know, a gear thing here. So I feel like that's important, that we know that this is here, we know that there's a switch that likely controls it, but it doesn't have power of some sort. So we need to figure out perhaps how to power it. I actually don't know. Like I said, this is a very, very heavy amnesia run. I remember sort of the basic principles of this game, but very little besides that. So we have a sort of a little Greek-inspired mini Parthenon thing, a door. We're going to open the door with a symbol on it. We have an examination chair. Okay, that's not creepy at all. Yeah, sure, why not? Sit in the creepy fucking red chair. January 101. March. 2nd. 5. So... Oh, okay, look, we have a whole view here. What is, the space chart. We're looking at, like, a star chart for this date and time. Obviously, there's, like, 4,000 million combinations here. The year 6328. Can we go to one of the dates that I'm familiar with? Witness the birth of Christ! Let's go to my birthday. Let's see what's up on my birthday. Because by the time you see this video, it's actually probably pretty close to my birthday. Well, I mean, not my actual birth date. You know when you were born? The exact time? I've seen my birth certificate, so I know for a fact that it's 8:11 a.m. Probably a cold morning, that February 5th. All right, so That's my birthday. Now that we've done that, let's do the curly knuckle symbol so we can get out of the chair. I don't know that there's anything else to do here except get out. Oh, wait. I can turn the light off. I don't know if that's relevant. Well, now I can see the star chart a little better. I think that's probably what you're supposed to do. I can roll this back and forth. I don't know if that's relevant. Let's get out of here. So the actual ceiling of this place. Can I go to free roam? Let's try free roam. Go to the controls. Yeah, so the actual ceiling of this building has the stars already on it. Let's get out of here. I have to use the... Yeah, I don't like the free roam. Fuck that. I just like clicking. I'm gonna put my other hand in my pocket and... just relax. One hand in my pocket and the other hand... blah, 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 blah. You guys like Alanis Morissette? She was pretty great back when this game came out. 1993, that was like the pinnacle of her career. Jagged Little Pill came out like the very next summer. I was... Alanis Morissette and Myst, man. That's my childhood. What do we got here in this little room? Tower rotation. So I don't know that we could do anything with this, but it is a map of tower rotation. And indeed, it resembles a map of the island. We started here next to the boat. We walked along this path up to the gear. We went into this little observatory, the star room. And now we're in this center room, which looks... Whoa. Shit. What can we... It's red. Tower rotation. Now what did we just do? There's a whole part of the island here we haven't even looked at yet. What have we done? We rotated a tower, which has yet been... I haven't seen it yet. According to the map, it was off to our left. But I pointed its red line towards this gear shift thing. I was wondering if maybe that gave it power. Here's the tower, though. So this is like a turret hole. And that is now facing our giant gear on the hill. I love that this game gives you absolutely no fucking... clue as to what you're supposed to be doing or what any of this is about. We don't have any pretext. We don't know when we are. We don't know where we are. We don't even know who we are. Am I even a human? Or am I just a floating fist in the space-time continuum here? We honestly don't know. What we do know is that there's a tower on that hill there. And can I look? I can't really look up at it. They don't want you to look up at it right now. I think that's what I like about the single point and click mode is that you can't look where you're not supposed to. And if I'm supposed to look at something, then I'll see it. It'll tell me on my screen, you know? Well, more or less. I wish they would light up what buttons you're supposed to know about, but... Am I in a fireplace? Am I gonna burn alive here? What are we playing, solitaire? What's going on here? All right, so you clearly have to input some sort of pattern onto that plate, the fireplace plate, and then maybe it'll do something. So we have the, I don't want to say the answers to our problems, but we know where we're supposed to put them. We have a blue book. Let's open it. All right. Now, I do remember the books, and I'll give you a bit of a spoiler here. The books contain... good old-fashioned video of real human actors playing the part of some of the few people in this game. This game does not have a lot of characters, but there's like two or three, and they show up in these books. And over time, we'll get more and more pages, and the pages... see, here we go. So this is sort of the technique it's showing you. You grab the blue page, and I hit, I want to go back to it. Actually, yeah, why don't I just save, yeah. You sure you want to save your game? Yes. Are you sure you want to? No, cancel. I want to save. How do I save? How do I save? Save. You sure you want to load? No, I want to save. How do I save? Is this button it? Anyway, pick up the blue page, drop it on the blue book. A weird sound effect happens, and now... And now we get more of the story.
Are you? See you. Help me. Ring, ring. Blue pages. Never and ever.
All right, so this guy's kind of weird, huh?
Just...
Hey, buddy, you ever heard of a wide-angle lens? I feel like you should back up and...
The blue page.
Right, so he's talking about some blue fucking pages. We got one blue page for him. And that's great. I think it's nice that we was able to help him out. What do we have here? Is this a window? What is this? I don't know what that is or what we're even looking at. It looks like... We're looking at another part of the island, but I can't be certain. I need to save this game. Can I give me help? What button saves? Save, this button. So, if it saves, why doesn't it show up over here? What's going on? Save my fucking game, would you? Oh, I just drag it? Right? Are you sure you want to save the game in slot 2? Save. Even the fucking menu is part puzzle, alright? Jesus. All right, so is a bookshelf. Maybe some blue pages are over here. Well, this one's been burnt to shit. Now, these are some of the original textures from the game that for some reason they didn't sort of reproduce for this realMyst Masterpiece Edition. I didn't want to do that. So I'm going to spare you the boredom of having to listen to me read every book on this shelf for the next hour. I've already gone ahead and done that, and a quick summary, every book on the shelf corresponds to different ages, which are the author's terms for these different worlds, these dimensions, these islands that we're going to visit throughout the game. The books sort of explain what each one looks like, who was there, and what the author is about, this narrator character, who we don't know yet. So since he's just an unnamed narrator, let's just call him Tyler Durden. He has two sons, Sirrus and Achenar, who come along on his journeys and visiting these different worlds. He paints a very vivid picture of each one of them, and the one we're on now is known as Myst. For some reason, though, I incorrectly identified it as Channelwood, which you may hear me mention throughout this Let's Play a couple times until I figure out my mistake a bit later. Also, the books are filled with clues, maps, and diagrams. I took screenshots of the relevant ones. That's the kind of game this is. It requires you to take notes and pay attention because they don't tell you anything twice. So those are all the books on the bookshelf. Now we have a better understanding of the place we're on and how this works. So the books... Sorry, what the fuck just happened? Holy shit, we opened up a portal. Okay, there's a lot of stuff to do. There's a lot of stuff going- Oh, wait. Now we can't get out. We can't get out. Can I close this? I can't. We have to either go down this hallway. There's so much to take in! I love it. I love games like this. So we have another book. So we have the blue book, the red book. These are the video books. We'll call them video books. We get a bunch of static, but if we drag the page... Now we get a wicked sound effect.
Why?
I'm Jonathan, nice to meet you. Say again? You didn't pay your DirecTV bill. You can't what? All right.
I am serious.
Oh, he's serious.
Give it up. There is one thing I'm going to rescue. You must.
Excuse me, I was just taking notes. So, we have learned that the red video book is Sirrus, which stands to reason the blue video book is Achenar, both of the narrator's sons. Okay, that's awesome. So this picture opens the door outside. That's why it wouldn't do anything before, because it was already open. And the other painting is a switch to open this door. So let's go in it and find out what's going on out here. Pop on the flashlight and head down these hallways. I have to say, re-exploring this Myst world 20 years later in this new 3D environment is really cool. Because it's sort of like how I remember it. If that makes sense. Like, when this game came out, the graphics were incredible. But if you actually tried to replay it today, well, one, Windows wouldn't let you install it because it doesn't work on anything above Windows XP. But two, you'd be like, these graphics are terrible. But instead, I'm enjoying how I remember. I remember it looking this good, when really, it wasn't. It looked like crap. And now we have a sort of updated version. I have to close the door, of course. An updated version with better graphics. This version, realMyst Masterpiece Edition, came out on my birthday last year in 2014. So it was like 20th anniversary edition of the game. And it looks and sounds a lot nicer than, you know, the original probably would have been. Can I go back here? Okay, so there's a good thing I went back here. October 11th, 1984, 10:04 a.m., January 17th, 12:07. So these are dates, obviously, but more importantly, they're star dates. All right, so I took a screenshot of the star dates so that when we get back to that satellite room, we can plug them in and see if they do anything. Let's go down the ladder. I don't know if there's anything to do up there. There's a little keyhole, though, and I want to investigate that. No. All right, well, it doesn't seem like I can really do anything. That's cool, though. This key behind the ladder is really sort of upsetting that I can't do anything with it. Okay, maybe we're not supposed, maybe it's just a sign. So that sign was a key, and there's nothing up there but that sign with the dates on it. And this ladder with a book on it goes to... This is the tower, and I've repositioned it so it faces the boat. We did that with the map downstairs on the side of the on the wall. That red line we spun around. Okay, how is this vantage point useful? Why is it important that I see out of this? What should it be looking at, I guess is a better question. All right, let's go downstairs. Back to the tower. I don't know why they call it a tower. It's more of a library, if anything. Alright, let's get the hell out of here. Is this the same place we started from? I can't go behind it. Yeah, this is where we came from, right? Yeah, this looks similar. Alright, we're back outside. Now, where else can the tower go? See, it pauses there. I don't know why it pauses there. What was the significance of the boat? I don't know. I do not know. Let's open the door and get out of here. So one door opens, the other door closes, and it's nighttime now. This is not something I think the original Myst did. I don't think they had nighttime and daytime. But the fact that they did is nice. The fact that they changed that in the updated version, this real Myst. The game is completely unchanged. The mechanics, the puzzles, they are all exactly the same. The only thing they've updated with this real Myst version is the graphics. They've just made it, they've made it look nicer. And more importantly, they've made it so you can actually play it on a 21st century computer. October 11th, 1984. Let's try it. Eerily close to some of the dates in Back to the Future. Because it's also 10:04, which is, if you're a Back to the Future fan like I am, you know that that's a specific date. So October 11th, 1984, 10:04 a.m. Hit the button. Oh, okay, shit. Now we have to match this symbol to the book that had But how does that help us? Now that we have some of these, all right, so we have one star chart finished. Let's plug the other ones in and see what that does. All right, here's the second day, January 7th, 1207, 5:46 a.m. Did not have to move that much for that second date. I'm double checking the date here in my screenshot and it looks correct. So I'm going to take another screenshot of the star chart so I can line it up later with the book. I have to say, taking screenshots is far easier than what my dad and I used to do back in 1994. Writing all this down in like a notepad and drawing sketches and stuff. And we had all these detailed drawings and it was so much. I remember like having to do homework for a video game for whatever reason was really exciting. Like forcing you to write stuff down. I love that the game like doesn't give you any help. And it's just, if you want to beat this, you just have to pay attention. And I always thought that was really cool. So I'm paying attention. I'm in. I'm excited. 9791. We gotta go way into the future for this one. Now we have our third. We can back out of our chair. Our creepy little star chair. Looks like you're going for a dentist office or something, but whatever. So let's go back inside the room that was known as the tower and see if we can match up the constellations with the ones I just found about. I think they were in this blue book. No, they weren't. They were in the bottom blue book. Yep. Nope, they weren't. They weren't about this one either. Wait, this one had a little thing with numbers on it. Is there any numbers in here? There were no numbers in any of these books. Good luck trying to... There's a stone ship. The stone ship had it. Okay. So. Let's see what we got. Does this one line up with anything? Negative. Does this one... Wait. Yes. Yes. The snake is January 17th. I'm gonna write that in my notes. Snake, January 17th. So this one lines up with January 17th. That much I figured out. This one is November 23rd. So this would, I'll just call it the beetle. All right, so the beetle lines up with that. And we have one more. And it's three in the top right and then five in the bottom left. This one. All right, four in the bottom left. Maple leaf. I can see that. Okay. October 11th, maple leaf. So now that we have symbols associated with these dates, now that we've done that homework and lined it up, what the fuck does that actually do for us? How does that... Maybe we have to plug it in here. Maybe these... We haven't been to this side of the island yet, so perhaps... we'll find out right now. What does this symbol do? Oh, it's a little mini boat. It's like the boat we just passed at the beginning of the game. All right. Oh, shit. Oh, now we know the three symbols. We have to press those three and those three only. Okay. That doesn't look like the beetle. That looks like a spider. That's the snake. We need the snake on. What we don't need is the eyeball. The eyeball was not one of the constellations. All right. This makes sense. Maple leaf. That's one of them. And the other one was the beetle. So let's find the beetle. I see a shipwreck. I see an arrow. I see a cross. And I see a flamingo. I'm guessing what I thought was a beetle is actually a spider. Nice! The ship is afloat. Did that affect the real one? Oh, it fucking did. It fucking did. Awesome. Now, you could have just clicked those animal buttons all willy-nilly. But this was way much better when you actually figured out the hard way. All right, let's go over to the boat. Let's check it out. There was still some stuff over there that I definitely want to investigate. There was a switch I didn't even touch, but we resurrected the pirate ship. Let's go. We got another book. Unfortunately, that will do it for this episode of Game Time, but please stay tuned for the next installment of the Myst Let's Play, where we advance to the Stone Ship Age and explore that whole new island. But if you prefer not to wait, you can watch that video right now by clicking the playlist link in the description below. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.